Imagine you wake up one day, screaming in pain and demanding to see a doctor as soon as possible. You walk into the doctor's office, the doctor simply looks at you and says, you look bad, you should get that fixed, and simply leaves the room. Sounds crazy, right? But what if I told you this is exactly the same way we have been treating our buildings for the past decades? Let's take a look at our schools, for example. Every year, we pay inspection professionals millions of dollars for them to simply look into our schools and hand in a report about a year later that basically says, what about your problems over there? You should get those fixed. This process takes so long and costs so much. By the time we get that information, there is almost nothing we can do to fix those problems. A year after year of delayed maintenance and these problems pile up. If you are lucky, you see a news article similar to the one on the slide, talking about the billions of dollars that we now have to pay to keep our schools functional. If you are not, we see a slightly different article, saying something has actually collapsed, and maybe someone has lost their life in the process. So what if there was a smarter, cheaper, and faster way to get the inspection results we are looking for, leaving us with enough time and money to do the fixing? This is where my research comes in. I am using image-based learning and analysis technology. The same technology behind those pop ears filters on Instagram and Snapchat. And I'm building a computer model smart enough that would look into images of buildings, collected by a drone for example, and point out where the cracks and different defects are, and classify them according to their condition. If a defect is critical, then it requires our immediate attention to fix it. But if it is fair or moderate, then maybe we can address it later. Not only that, but I'm making my model even smarter. I'm teaching it how different defects were fixed before, using past maintenance contracts, and this way, the model can suggest ways to fix the defects at hand, and even estimate the time and cost required. Something that has never been accomplished before. While I'm building the model using images of schools and universities collected from all over Canada, the model can be further expanded to include all the different kinds of buildings, and even bridges and roads, both in Canada and all over the world. This way, and within minutes, we know not only what problems do we have, but also how bad they are, and most importantly, how to get those fixed. While they say a picture is worth 1,000 words, in my model, pictures are worth billions of dollars, and in some cases, lives of our families and friends.